Welcome students, welcome to our session 3 of database in the online live classes of KVS RO Jabalpur. Dear students, hope you have enjoyed and understood well the first two sessions. Though I agree, the first session was very much theoretical, while the second session we proceeded with some theory and some practicals. Today in this session, I have kept lot of practicals for you people. And as I always say, I want you all students to keep the notes and pen ready because we are going to have lot of practice today, lot of practicals today. Today we will be learning the DDL queries and DML queries. In previous session also, we have worked on MySQL client. I believe you all know how to start MySQL client and get it ready for the practical work. So let me start my PPT and show you what we are going to do today. So coming to the PPT, I want to again declare that today on this date of 25th April for the live classes, I have kept ready the DDL and DML queries for you all. In the previous session, we proceeded from general concepts to the next portion, that is our data types in databases or SQL. Today we are going to see the SQL commands, as I have already said. In this slide I added few more arrows, just want to show how and which portion of IP and CS are very much related, while this basics is compulsory for everyone. So these related portions are shown by the arrow. Take a glance of this slide and see how benefited are both the students of IP and CS with this common class. They will have all the knowledge of SQL and databases. I am going further to my slide. As usual, this is my habit, good or bad. I would like to say that somehow I always want to recapitulate the things. You always have to review what you studied. And so here it is. Let me just see. Yes, today in previous session we have learned how to create a database, how to open or use the database, and how to list the tables in any database. Do you remember the commands? Can you think of what commands were they? I always remember, because as I said yesterday in my previous session also, that this particular SQL I feel very interesting and I love to work on SQL. Let me see if we have solutions for them. Right, we have the solutions. We created the database with create database and database name given by us. Do not forget to put a semicolon. Similarly, we used database by the command use db name. The third question, I said how to list the tables. The command was show tables. So if you remembered it, it was well and good. If you have not done any review, we are doing it right now. I am going to the next slide. I hope you have noted it down again, and noting down twice or thrice, it always goes to the permanent memory. So in next slide, I want to show you what will be our today's journey. See, in our today's journey, we are going to have the SQL commands, the actual SQL commands that is in our syllabus. And so we will be doing that part here. We will be having this create table command, alter command, and drop command. These three commands, they come in the category of this DDL query. Similarly, in the category of DML queries, what comes is the insert, update, and delete command. Today, our focus will be here in these three commands, and then if time permits, we will proceed to further next commands. Let's see. Before coming to the next topic, I again want to say, to learn and understand databases, to work on SQLs, you all must have a previous knowledge of few things, which includes what is a database, what is DBMS, what are RDBMS, data types, and also about the MySQL. These few things, a knowledge about them will make you powerful and ready to learn SQL. So I hope and wish my previous classes are beneficial for you people that you know these all things. In previous class, we have seen these commands. I am showing it again so that you have a review, you learn it, you understand it, and you try it again and again. They come to be beneficial whenever we are working on SQL, though they are not very much mentioned in all the syllabus part. So, actual topic of today, that is our DDL command. In my previous session, I already said DDL commands are going to work with the structures of the object in any database. So here, as per our syllabus, the structure that we are going to use will be table. So table is something that we have to work upon, and DDL commands are going to do work over the structure of table by creating them, altering them, and dropping them. What are these commands? Create, alter, drop. I normally write the acronym CAD for my students so that they remember these three commands of DDL are create, alter, and drop. You will never forget with this shortcut. You can make your own shortcuts as you wish. The syntax of create table, how to write a create table query, will work on MySQL client also. But before that, let's see some basics. We have to write these queries or whatever the query in SQL always in the front of MySQL client. So let's keep our MySQL also ready for the moment. Let me see. Is it ready? Yes, it is visible to me. I haven't logged in. Let me log in also. So giving the password authentication. As I already said, I haven't kept a password for my ease because this is my personal system. Our MySQL is ready. So where do we write the commands? We write it here in the front of MySQL prompt. I hope you have understood it through the previous session, as well as many of you are already practiced where to write the commands. So this is about the MySQL. Coming back to our slide portion, in the transition, we were here in the create table portion. Yes, this create table, how to write it now? In front of the prompt ending will be here, like this greater than symbol is showing here. Create table, you have to write there. Table name. The table name is always given by the user. ATS1C1. What are these things? Very simple, very simple. Don't worry. I am going to explain them also. A1, T1, S1, C1 written in the short cut form. A1 represents any attribute. It can be represented by AN or AI. Any attribute. Attribute means columns. Okay. And T1 is the data type of that attribute. S1, the size of that attribute. C1, if any constraint we are going to put for that attribute. So as many as columns I want to make in my table, I will write that many comma separated attributes with their definition to create a table. Once again, create table, table name, attribute, type, size, constraint, comma. Second attribute, type, size, constraint, comma. And up to the last attribute I want to keep in my table, and closed by the bracket, end of SQL is always with the semicolon, correct? End of any SQL statement is always with the semicolon. So it is here. In my previous slide, I am using C, C and C here and saying it is a constraint. What is constraint? I used somewhere in previous lecture also. Any one of you remember? I hope most of you remember. These constraints, I will talk about them in detail here so that it do not makes you confused or it do not affects you in the terms of making a query. So let's come here. Constraints. So what are constraints? Please see this slide. Maybe you will get some idea so that you can perform it here. Fine. I'm going to explain it. Constraints. Constraints are the rules they are enforced over the columns of any table. Why they are used? They are used so that they can limit the type of data, what type of data we can use, and the accuracy and reliability of the data. What data should come in, what data should not come, which type of data, and what are the rules over those data. Constraints define them. So constraints can be applied over two levels. The column level, that means whenever we write in the front of column, it is called as column level. But when we write after defining the whole table, that means all the columns of any table, at the end we write the constraint, then we call it as table level constraint. So there are six very famous constraints: unique, not null, primary key, foreign key, check, and default. So details of these constraints, I am here depicting them by a symbol also. See, the limitations as well as the expansions and the validations, they are the indicators of the constraints. Not null. If I say any column has a constraint of not null, it means that this constraint ensures that column cannot have any null value. For example, in the student table, if I want to enter the details of any students, I can say name of a student should be not null. Similarly, unique, it ensures that the column entries, the data entry in any column, it should never be duplicate, it should not be repeated, it should always be different. But here, null values are also allowed. Null values are also allowed. Okay, so unique and not null, the first two constraints. When we combine the feature of this not null and unique, we get a third constraint and we call it as primary key. This key has been defined earlier with dot of stress. But remember, primary key, which is combination of not null and unique, it ensures whatever the key we have made as primary key in our database, it should never be empty. The data there should always be there, and the data should not be repeated in any condition. It has to be unique for all the entries. And you must agree, in terms of roll number also, all the students have a different roll number. That is why we decide normally to make roll number column as the primary key column in any class or student database table. Fine. The foreign key I have already defined in previous sessions also, and you understand it. This uniquely identifies a row or record of another table and connects the table. The new one is check. Check constraints, they help you to give a condition, a specific condition that should be checked or should be fulfilled by the particular column. To set a default value, a fixed value, when user do not enters any value, the fixed value is taken up by the default specified constraint. Index is used to create and retrieve data in a quick manner. This is though not mentioned in your syllabus, I have simply kept it here. So we have how many things here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. The six constraints are here for you people. Let us start creating the table. As I said earlier, create table and then table name, column name, data type, and constraint. Column name, data type, the next constraint, whatever constraints we want to make. I'm giving here an example. When you want to create a table student, you can start with create table student. The attributes here mentioned are admission number, name, age, and class. So we have to start a bracket. Then the first column or attribute, with its type, size, and the constraint. Once again, the first column, the type, the size, and the constraint. All things are mentioned here. And constraint is optional. It is not necessary that you always put a constraint like here. Like here. It is not necessary that you always put a constraint. Okay. So in this way, you can always define a table. You can create a table. Before giving you this particular assignment, I want to come back to my SQL client. And let's start working on that. So if you remember, just a minute, I'll come back to my SQL client here. Just a minute. Yes. So we are here. This is our MySQL client. And yesterday we learned the creation of a database. We learned how to use the database. Today we are going to start and revise them again in a quick manner. And here I am going to start with a database called as school. And we are going to keep it fixed for our going on sessions, the further sessions. So our database will be school, and here I will be creating some table and I will be showing you the queries further in the same database. What is the command for creating database? You can write in your copy if you know. I am writing it here for you people. It is create database school. Let me see if it creates. Very happily it created, because database school do not existed earlier. Do you want to see the list of databases? I will use the show databases command and I will see it here. In the previous one, we created online classes as a database, and today I have created school. For my testing phase, when I installed, I created a database called as test. So our database school is ready. I am going to use it by the command. Let me just scroll it up for you. Yes. Use. And what should I write here? School. Now I am in my database school and I can start working here. What should I do now? Let me see what should I do now. Just a minute, I'll just check what to do here. Correct. Here we are going to write a query to create the table. Let's see how to create a table. For this, I kept one more thing ready for you people, and that is a ready table command, how to create a table with all the constraints. Should I come there or should I give you one assignment? Because I have already told you a small create table query. I believe I should show you first that particular query so that you all can try, and let me see, you can gain some confidence. Okay. So coming back to our slide, are you all able to create this query? Think of, I have given only two constraints and then simple commands. The attribute names are here, employee number, employee name, post, city, with their type, and everything is mentioned. And such questions always come in your exam. They normally come as a 2 marks question. And I wish and I hope all of you are able to do this question successfully. Are you thinking? Yes. I am showing you the solution also. I created this solution, and just see whether your solution matches or not. For this table, I am only watching the question. It says write an SQL command to create table. It says write an SQL command to create table salary. So the name of table is salary. I started here, create table salary. Bracket starts. The very important thing. Then you have to write the attribute name, EMP number, type is integer, because size is not mentioned here. I have also not mentioned any size. You can leave these brackets also when size is not mentioned. Primary key and comma. So, attribute name, type, size, constraint. The second constraint is here, amp name, varchar 20, not null. Yes, it is also done here. Post, varchar 10. Okay, I have forgot to write the constraint size here, or maybe because of numlog feature it happened. So you can always enter a 10 here. Write a 10 here in the brackets. In the same way, in the city also, write the size 10. And then salary as decimal. There was no size given. I decided to give an appropriate size. Okay. So in this way, you can always create a table. For my students, I normally tell them simply start with a create table. Put a create table in front of the name of table and then start a bracket here, end a bracket here, put a semicolon here, give so many commas as many are the attributes, and then you are able to create a query if question comes in this form. So let me see. I have made a query which is showing all the constraints in a single query, and we are going to make a table like this only. Here I tried to make the primary key as ID, UBI ID as not null and unique. Yes, I want to tell this thing. You can give more than one constraint to a column also by writing this way. Then name varchar is not null, address has no constraints. City has a default option for river. If user is not going to enter any value, it will contain city as river. Marks is given as a check constraint for marks greater than 0. That means a user can enter anything but should not be less than 0. And I have tried to mention the foreign key also through the command, the keyword references. Library ID, which is of integer type 3, it refers, see the word references, it refers the library table for its column library number, and note down the alert. This library table should be a pre-created table, an existing table, so that you can link it with the table student through foreign key. If the table library do not exist, you may not be able to create the foreign key constraint here. Okay, come to the practical aspect. As we decided, I am coming to MySQL portion, and I want it to write. I am going to write this query. You people can also try the same query here. Just a minute, I'll just see. I have kept this query ready because not to waste your time. Excuse me. Fine. So here what happened, I have written and I have copied the same query that I kept in my this PPT. It is written here, but I'm not going to take this query. I'm going to take the second query, and that is create table query without the foreign key. Why have I done this? Only because for the reason my library table is not ready. So currently I am not able to show you the foreign key constraint. So okay, so continuing with the create table query, I am coming back to the notepad and I'm writing the create table query here. You all can read it. Create table student ID as integer 6, primary key, then you have the UBI ID, not null, unique, few constraints are given here. S name, varchar, length of 35, and address varchar 35. I have added the primary key constraint, not null and unique constraint. And let's create a query here. Let's see whether this query comes fine or not. So putting an enter here. Query, okay, zero rows affected. So it means our table has been created. Will you like to see the table? It is visible here with show tables command. That is why I said you in the slides that those commands are very important. There are two tables, student and students. The students table is a table that I have made just now for you people, and student is a table that I have made for a practice purpose. So student table is ready. Now you all can write create table query, and it is easy, I believe. Fine. So let us come back to the slide and see some more things there. It is here, PPT part. Fine. So I am back to our slide. Create table query, various defaults, references we have seen, but right now I am not using the references. Coming to the next one. Now we have to see the alter table query, that is a DDL query. This DDL query, why do we use it? It works with the settings of the structure, settings of the table structure. That means whenever we have to deal with the table structure, we have to work on the table schema, then we are going to use the alter table query. What is the thing that alter table query can do? It can work on various aspects of a table. If you can see it here, it can decrease the number of columns. Our desired column can be removed. The desired columns can be added or even modified. So removing a column, adding a column, modifying a column, and not only column but also constraints. So let us see further the definitions. Alter table statement is used to add, delete, and modify the columns of any existing table, and along with that you can add or drop, that is delete, the constraints on any table. So proceeding further, how to do them? Alter table and table name. One more thing I want to tell you. For any DDL query, you have to remember what is the identity. Kya pehchan hai kisi DDL query ki? Alter table ya create table ya drop table. Do you see the name of object is here? What do we want to do is on the table. So we are using the keyword table. This keyword table is missing in DML queries. Here in create also you were able to see the word table. In alter also you are able to see the word table, and in drop also the word table will be visible. So alter table query, let's proceed here. Alter table query can add any attribute. Attribute means column. It can modify any attribute. It can drop any attribute. We have already seen in the previous slide. I am repeating it again and again so that you never forget what are the powers of alter table query. It has many variations. It can add a primary key. I said add constraints. In your example, I will be taking adding a primary key. It can drop a primary key. So let us see few examples here. To add existing in an existing table, to add the columns. The variation of alter table is alter table and the table name. Then you have to write add column. Column name, that means it's a data type and size. This column word is optional here. Okay, it is optional. You may or may not use it. A very simple example: alter table student add DOB. DOB is what type? Date type. Whenever we are going to enter a new column, if the table already has columns, the new column will have all the values as null value. But when we are creating a new table, as we have done right now, all the columns are right now having the null value. So will you like to do this query? I am ready for that. I am coming to MySQL client, and yes, it is here ready. And in our student table, I want to see how it looks. So I will see the description of student table. Students. Yes. Whatever I created is visible here. It contains an ID, UBI ID, S name and address, but few things are missing. I think we should have a marks column here. And any other column you want? You can add a column using the alter query. Alter table. What is the name of your table? Students. So alter table students. Then add. I want to add marks. What is the type of marks? It is int of the size 3. And let me see. It says query OK. And now if you see the description of the table students. Yes, yes, yes. Marks column is here. I want to show it once again. What do you want to add now? Do you want to add some more things here? Okay, same column you cannot add again and again because the column name must be unique. So here we can add a grade with char. Let me say 2. And also I want to add some more things like do we have a city column here? No, we don't have. I am adding a city column also. City bear care 35. I am taking this example just only to show that as many as columns you can add using the comma separator. Something is wrong. Let me see what happened there. Do we have a city column? You have an error. City where care 35. Alter table students. Add grade care to city where care 35. Okay, I will check it once again. Otherwise, I will take the problem in my next session. What's wrong here? I'm not getting at this moment. City column was already not there. City. I'm changing the data type simply for a purpose. And this. Semicolon. Some error. I'm not getting what is there. Care 35. Maybe it is because of two columns. Let me make a bracket here. And check it. Yes. Because there are more than one column, it required a bracket so that it can accumulate whatever the columns it has to create. Though I have felt this problem first time. I never felt like this. Anyhow, we are able to run the query and now you can see the description of the students. We are here with a table having marks, grade and city, the new column. Okay. Can we come back to our slide? Let's see what more is there in our show of PPT. Alter table query. I hope you all have understood. Now, modification of the existing column. So you are able to see the query. I will come directly to the MySQL client and show you there. Coming to the MySQL client. See, you have already created a column and I feel the city character 5 I must change as varchar because varchar is a better one. So here this time I am going to use modify command or action of the alter query. Okay, so alter table students modify. I want to modify which column? City and new data type of the city. I'll make it where care. Caps lock is on. Okay, here I want to tell you one more point. It is a case insensitive, so no need to worry. It will always work. I have made it where care 35, so make it let me make it 40 and run it. It says query OK and the new description contains where care 40. So now you know how to modify it also. Once again back to PPT show and let's see what is it. Alter query is done. Similarly, you can change the existing column. New column name can be given to any old column. You have simply to write alter table student and change. The keyword here is change. What is the keyword here? It is change. And this change will simply change the old column name class as S class. New data type and size is obvious to be given. So alter table student, change class, that means the old column name and the new column name. Old column name, New column name should contain all the definitions. Then you can delete a column. Alter table, then table name. Alter table student. In our case, it is students. Drop column. You have to write the keyword here, column also. This is a better option. Drop column and the column name you want to drop. Let us try this. In our MySQL client, I want to drop the grade column right now. So alter table. Table name is students and I want to drop let's say grade column. So column, drop column, and I will write grade. I don't have to tell the description, and it says very good, whatever you desired is already done. So let's see the description. No grades column is here. So I hope now you find it easy how to run the queries in SQL. Let me proceed a bit quick now. How to alter a constraint? I have already made a primary key, but suppose if you forget to make a primary key in any table, you can alter the table, alter table, table name, add primary key. For example, you want to delete a primary key. Once again, if you want to delete a primary key, it will be alter table, the table name, drop primary key. Okay, so I am not showing you in the MySQL client these commands. And the last command of the DDL query, it is drop table command. It deletes the relation from the database. If you say drop table, it will delete the complete table with its structure and it will not exist further in your database. I have made a sample table student there. I'll show you so that you are able to understand this thing. That is why I kept another table for the practice purpose. This is my SQL client, and see, I have shown you that how to see the table. Show tables command. I have two tables, student and students. Students table is the table I am working currently for you people. And student table is same, similar type of table. I want to delete it. And let me see how to do it. So what is the command I have told you for that is drop table and the table name. So I'm writing it here, drop table. And what is the name of my table? Student. Should I click and enter? It will be deleted. I am doing so for you people. Query okay. And now do you find this table again? Went away. Now no more student table. Okay. So this table query, deleting a table, has also been done for you people. I want to summarize for today that in DDL queries, after the drop table, we have deleted the table also. It will delete it permanently. And then let us have few assignments. Okay, then we'll see other things. The questions for you people are here in the slide. Please read it and if possible, write it quickly. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you. Don't worry when table is not given and how will you write the query. This is always whenever first time I give the questions of query to my students. Madam, table nahi hai, how to do it? How to write a query, table dikh hi nahi raha hai, table visible nahi hai. No, you don't have to bother whether the table is there or not. You simply have to read the query. Query is self-containing one. Self-contained description is there in the query. It tells you always the name of the table you require to use. It tells you what to do. Then what else do you need? It tells you what to do, then what else do you need? You simply need a place to write a query. You simply need to write the query by watching the query language only. I hope I can show you here somewhere. Okay, I will show you only the notepad and how to write the query. I am coming with the notepad part. Notepad is available with MySQL, and that is available in PPT. What is our query? Do you remember? Let me see, what was our query? Our query was, note it down. Our query was SQL statement to add a column region ID to the table locations. So our table is locations, and we have to add a column. Quite clear, it is an alter query. Alter table, and the table name is locations. It is visible here, so use it. Alter table locations, and then what do you require to do is add a column. So what is our keyword? Add. You have to add a column. The name of the column is given here in your question. It is region ID. Region ID underscore region ID. And how to add a column? We have to give some data type and size. So I have given varchar 30 and simply semicolon. Okay, I'm writing the same for you people so that you understand it well. MySQL client, yes, it is here. My notepad is here and I am writing it here. It is visible here. Let's see. Alter table. What is the table name? Location or locations. It was locations. So use the correct name. Otherwise, it will give an error. Add column is optional. You want to add region ID. Region ID. And what type of region ID is it? Varchar 30. So I have done this varchar 30 and put an enter. This will do the work. I am showing this because I want to tell you that you do not need a table to show the whole things. You simply need a query, and your query will tell you everything. Like in second one, you have to change the data type of column country. So which query? Again, you require a alter table query. You have to drop a column in the third one. What query? Yes, alter table query. You have to add a primary key. Again, alter query. And these all alter queries are DDL queries. And the last question is just for exploration because it is a table level constraint that I didn't tell you how to write. Okay, so you explore it first, then in my next session I will tell you. These questions are for your assignment. It will be nice if you note them down. Okay, please note it down so that you can solve it in your copies also. And I request other subject teachers watching the live classes, as well as the subject teachers of the concerned KVs, please give them few assignments so that they can perform the practice work and they can write over their copies and they will never forget. For our next session, we have the DML commands which work on the data values of a table. It is a simple series of commands like today we had for DDL queries. So I think the time limitation is saying me to stop here, and we'll see the things next time. I hope today in this practical session you people like the query practical work. You were able to understand whatever the commands I proceeded here with. And you had been able to see various commands of DDL without any confusions. Moreover, when your teachers will give you the practice things, it will be much more easier for doing the work in SQL. And please practice it, because your final topic, your project work, it will depend a lot on your SQL portion also. Python, when combines with SQL, it becomes powerful. Or I will say any front end when combines with SQL, it becomes powerful. I hope you all had a good study time over here. Once again, going back to meet you all soon for the next class. wish you all a very happy day and a good study time at home. Fine and bye.